Well, good evening, guys. It's Bim's o'clock. We've got some purple sprouted broccoli for this year. Some sweet corn. It's late, I know, but we've had a disastrous thing with it. Apples are doing okay on the trees. Sweet pea flowers. Last of the international kidney. Got to give a shout out to my brother from another mother, Jay. He watches these, but he doesn't do videos. These are the Anyas that we're going to be having at the barbecue in August. Strawberries over here. Doing okay, getting quite a lot of strawberries. Barrow looking lovely. Got a hen with chicks just here. Some Peking chicks in there, and just some Red Island Red Crosses. There's the ferrets. All the ferret kits are in here. Yeah. Anna drinking Pimm's, using her little shopping basket to pick peas. Pumpkin. Potatoes all doing well. Leeks in down here. What survived the birds? Potatoes are doing really well. These are the main crops, our Pomera. Tomatoes. I know Jay has just snapped one of his tomatoes and it was doing really well. Beetroot. Got a cucumber in there as well. Carrots. First early potatoes. Onions, we got some mega onions.
Mole's been in.
Is it a mole?
Is that a cat?
More carrots, more tomatoes, tumbling tomatoes. Strawberries, peppers haven't really done well this year. We don't eat that many peppers anyway. Show carrots. We don't eat that many peppers, so it's pointless us growing them, to be honest. So we just grow one or two. It's pointless, really, because they're cheap enough to buy or swap out with a friend. I don't know why Hannah's sat there. Chickens doing okay. Ducky and red. Black currants. We'll have to start taking some black currants off these soon because they're getting absolutely chocker with dark ones. More peas. We're starting to flower now. More peas over there, more peas. Climbing green beans, runner beans. Peas across the back there. Brassicas doing okay. The other little chicks are all out. Doing really well. Rabbit over here. And the ducks, muscovies. Got a broody hen in there on eggs. I'll take a perch here and talk to you. Barney's here doing okay. Savoy's doing really well. Some sprouts at the back there, kale, greyhound cabbage, and what's left of the collies here. All doing well. What else? Carrots in the raised bed at the back there with the dwarf beans in. They're all doing well there as well. Pretty much it, really, of an update for the plot and the garden. Where the potatoes are going, is going to be a couple of no dig beds next year. We've got some manure coming in at some point in the next couple of weeks. That's going to be stacked up over here somewhere, just out the way. Let it start rotting down. We'll also be adding compost manure to the raised beds in the poly. Obviously turning the potato bed into a no-dig bed. We're not sure what we're going to be growing where the peas are at the back there next year. We'll see if we can find something to put in. We're going to grow pims, are we, Han? We're not sure whether to do Sarpo Mira again next year as a main crop. We are looking at Desiree because we have done we have done Desiree before. And yes, we are looking at Cara as well as a main crop.
Cara.
Yeah.
We're doing Cara.
International Kidney and Charlotte, I think, as the second earlies and salads. And some extra Cara. I can't remember. Yeah, Nicola maybe. There's one, I can't remember the name of it. It's a heritage variety.
Home Guard,
that's the name. Froggy. Aaron Pilot, I think. I bent my ear over.
Pim's o'clock.
So, it's cold. No.
I'll shut up now. I'm going to ruin your video.
So, that's pretty much it, really, guys. There's nothing else we can say, really. Everything's just coming, starting to come good now for harvesting.
Ooh. Two cauliflowers ready.
Yeah, no one's blown, hasn't it? Yeah. One's blown and started going to seed. We've got some first runner beans. No, there's a couple on this end. Yeah. They're quite big.
Don't scare them.
As you can see, we took out an old cherry tree and the plum tree. They weren't that great, to be honest. The poor apple tree in the corner. We decided we're going to take all the fruit off of it next year and just let it do its thing, let it establish a root base. We should have done that last year, really, or this year, but never mind. We just tie it up. But yeah, everything else is coming good. We're starting to keep on top of the strimming and bits and bobs now. Yeah, we'll be overrun with black currants, but we'll make some black currant jam and try some black currant.
Oh, we've got one dwarf nectarine.
One dwarf nectarine. Wow. We're going to try some black currant wine or something as well. We've got plenty of them. So. Peapod wine, yeah, we're going to try that as well with the purple peapods from up the back there. We planted some more peas. And that's about it, really, guys.
I might pull this bag of taters down here.
Yeah.
Aww, that was a goose sneeze.
Goose sneeze. They got hay fever. Just in that door there to the chicken shed is where the meat birds are. Obviously we've been out today, so they haven't been out free ranging, but we're going to go open the door up in a minute and let them out for the last couple of hours this evening, get a bit of sun on the backs. They're normally out. We have a couple of pieces of Perspex that we put up as a pen for them, but obviously with us being out today, I didn't want to risk that blowing over while we're not here. So, like I say, Just another shout out to Jay, my brother from another mother.
Reached the 10-minute mark.
10 minutes. He wanted me to give him a shout out on here. So there
love
we go.
You, Jay. Not in a weird way though.
No. So there we go, guys. That's pretty much it for an update. It's there's not a lot really going on. Just little bits of harvesting coming in here and there. A few little bits that we're still planting. Still planting a few carrots here and there. Planted some more peas just to try and squeeze in the last little bit of a crop towards the end of the season, but all the cabbages and things like that, we'll just be taking them as and when we want them. We've basically dumped from last year a good 30 litre buckets worth of cabbage, a bit of cauliflower, and some other little bits and bobs from the plot that, you know, we used a bag each Sunday and we still had loads left, but it had started to seem to be turning because it was quite vinegary, slushy when we was steaming it. So anyway, things will be picked fresh and eaten fresh. So there we go, guys, that's pretty much it. We'll catch you in the next one. Cheers for now. Pim's up.